Hi, I'm Conservation Officer Glenn Lucas with the New Hampshire Fish and Game Department. Our department is your connection to life outdoors. We promote this connection to be done in the safest way possible. With that in mind, we ask you to take the next few minutes to watch this video and familiarize yourself with the general operation of a snowmobile. As you can see here, a snowmobile is a machine that is driven by a revolving track and turned with two skis. The accelerator is on the right side of the handlebars, operated by the thumb. And the brake is on the left side of the handlebars, operated by the left fingers. If the machine is equipped with a tether cord, it is always recommended that it be attached to your pants or jacket. This cord will shut the machine off if disconnected. It will not apply the brakes when it is disconnected, however. The throttle, located in front of the right grip, is connected to the motor and is a variable input lever that controls your speed. Since it is operated by your thumb, special attentions must be put into holding onto the handlebar while riding, since your whole hand will not be closed around the grip. The brake, located behind the left grip, is a lever that will slow your speed and/or stop all rotation of the track. Careful application of this lever is also important because different pressure will affect how your machine slows and/or stops. We can all stand being a little cold for a short period of time. However, once riding a snowmobile, you have to keep in mind that you will be creating and increasing wind chill as your speed increases. Layering with non-cotton layers is important, with a wind-resistant outer layer being the most important. Winter gloves and winter boots are also a must. Above all, a proper-fitting helmet is the most important riding gear to wear while operating a snowmobile. Conservation officers have covered multiple accidents where victims wearing a proper helmet survived and recovered much better. Being balanced on a snowmobile is a hard thing to understand while riding slow around a field. However, when you understand how and why a machine works, it becomes clear that the pressure and weight needs to be applied to the inside of a turn at higher speeds in order for the machine to stay on the trail. Steering a snowmobile is more than just pushing and pulling the handlebars. Because your right thumb is on the gas and not able to push when turning left, your left hand needs to compensate by pulling more. Also, being aware of the throttle position while turning to make sure it does not hit your leg or any other obstructions is important. A snowmobile is named just that because it is meant to operate on snow. On any other surface other than snow, the machine will handle poorly or simply not at all. Avoid driving on pavement other than at a perpendicular trail crossing. A machine will cross a road at a 90-degree angle just fine. Ice is similar to pavement. The skis will not bite into the ice and the machine will not turn as planned. Use extreme caution in very slow speeds when riding on ice or on icy trails and corners. Snowmobiles are meant to operate on specific approved trails. Operation off of approved trails is illegal and can be dangerous. Objects like rocks, stumps, and poles can be hidden under the snow. Operate a machine at slow speeds in an open area before venturing off onto the trails. Become familiar with the machine to a point of confidence. Riding a snowmobile on the trails can be quite enjoyable. But remember, there are others on the trail as well. They will be coming at you without anything separating the lanes. The speed limit for a snowmobile is 45 miles per hour in New Hampshire. However, that's not always the maximum at every location or on every trail. The speed limit is the speed at which you can control the machine and avoid any and all collisions. Here's an example. If the trails have limited snow cover and the corners are icy, then an enforceable speed limit may be 10 miles per hour. Numerous tickets have been issued where operators were going well below 45 miles per hour, but were still in violation because they were going too fast for the conditions. When riding, keep your eyes ahead of you, watching for obstructions and other obstacles that may appear on the trail. Be courteous when stopping on the trail and move your machine to trail edges. Avoid parking in large groups that spill out onto the trail. Our training division and enforcement division does not promote hand signals for oncoming riders or signaling how many people are behind them. A snowmobile should be expected around every corner. No one should be depending on hand signals as to how many riders they may encounter. Hands should be kept on the handlebars at all times, especially with oncoming riders. With all these things to keep in mind, we leave you with a few more important messages. Drugs and alcohol do not mix when riding a snowmobile. Operating a machine requires your undivided attention. Stay on the marked trail, no matter where someone else has left tracks. You are riding on public and private property. Every trail is a privilege and can be taken away because of one bad act. Please enjoy the natural beauty that New Hampshire has to offer. Not everyone gets an opportunity to see it through a snowmobile helmet.
Thanks for watching our video and be safe out there.